हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अल्कोहल, फिनॉल्स एंड ईथर्स। एज वी नो दैट इन अवर लास्ट सेशंस वी कंटिन्यू विथ अवर जर्नी विथ एनसीईआरटी एग्जाम्पलर। सो इन लास्ट सेशंस वी कंप्लीटेड अप टू 40 क्वेश्चंस एंड देयर सॉल्यूशंस एंड नाउ वी स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम 41। वी नो दैट मेनी क्वेश्चंस इन दिस एक्सरसाइज एज वेल एज अनसॉल्व्ड क्वेश्चंस, सॉल्व्ड क्वेश्चंस एंड दिस एग्जाम्पलर्स, दे आर some questions are they are the similar in nature, so we can discuss in a very brief manner. So the question is asked like that. In 41 number question is like that: explain why the hydroxyl group in the phenols more strongly held as compared to the hydroxyl group in the alcohol. We all know that in phenol the oxygen of the hydroxyl group is bonded to a sp2 carbon of the benzene ring. And we know that this, due to the resonance, we know that all the five structures of the resonating structure that we have to discuss in our theoretical portions, out of these three structures having a C double bond O bond, in other words, C O carbon oxygen bond in phenol have some double bond characteristics, while in alcohol it's always is a single bond characteristics, so it's a pure single bond. Therefore, the hydroxyl group in phenols more strongly as compared to the alcohols. Next one, explain why the nucleophilic substitutions reactions are not very common in phenol. In phenol, the oxygen atom of hydroxyl group delocalizes the lone pair of electrons over the benzene ring, and as a result, the electron density on the benzene ring increases, which makes difficult for the nucleophiles to attack due to repulsions, right? So next one, 43 number questions: preparations of alcohols from alkenes involves the electrophilic attack on alkene carbon, explain its mechanism. हमने तीन बार ये questions, पहले हमने theoretical portion में भी देखा था, फिर वो NCERT exercise में भी देखा था, अभी तीसरी बार हम ये देख रहे हैं कि इसका mechanism बताइए. So, electrophilic attack by hydronium ion over to the H2SO4. So, it's converted into hydronium. And now, this hydronium ion is attack on alkene. Okay? It's a slow step and we know that it's a rate determinating state. Right? Next one, this carbocation is further reacts with a lone pair of water and it's converted into protonated alcohol. And now, this protonated alcohol, now they deprotonate or they lose proton to form an alcohol. Next one, question number 44. Explain why is CO2 is non-polar while ROR is polar. We know that in the case of CO2, your central atom carbon does not have a lone pair, while in this case O having a lone pair. Okay? So it's a linear in nature. Same way, this compound must be linear, but is sp3 hybridized, right? So this can be explained by the molecular geometry. The CO2 molecule is linear. R2O is a bent or angular in shape. Thus, in case of ether, the bond moments do not cancel each other, and so the molecule possesses the net dipole moment. In case of CO2 molecule, the bond moments are oriented exactly in opposite directions and cancelling each other. So that's the reason behind that. Why is the reactivity of all classes of alcohols with concentrated HCl and zinc chloride with the help or Lucas reagent is different? We know that the reactions of alcohols with concentrated hydrochloric acid and ZnCl2 means Lucas reagents occurs through intermediate formation, right? And of carbocations. Obviously, more stable the carbocation, more reactive is the alcohol. So the stability of carbocation follows the order tertiary, secondary and primary. Therefore, the reactivity of alcohol towards Lucas reagent follows the same order tertiary, secondary and primary. And we know that in the case of tertiary, so within a fraction, so oily drops are observed on the upper surface. While in the case of secondary, so our solutions must be milky in nature after 2 or 3 minutes. And if there is no change in the solutions or mixture, so it means it's a primary in nature. Next, number 46. write the steps to carry out the conversions of phenol to aspirin. We want to prepare aspirin, right? We know that it's an analgesic drugs, it's a painkiller drugs, but it starts from phenol. First, it's converted into NaOH with the sodium hydroxide. So, water molecule is removed and it's converted into sodium phenoxide. Now, sodium phenoxide is react with the carbon dioxide at 125 degree centigrade temperature and 4 to 7 atmospheric pressure. And then after acidified, so it's converted into salicylic acid. And further the salicylic acid, your hydroxyl group is reacted with a acetic anhydride or acetyl chloride. Acylation reactions in presence of H gives a 2-acetoxybenzoic acid or aspirin or acetyl salicylic acid. Nitration is an example of aromatic electrophilic substitution reactions. And its rates depends upon the group already present in the benzene ring. Out of benzene and phenol, which one is more easily nitrated? We know that the nitration of a benzene and phenol is an electrophilic substitution reaction. And the rate of any electrophilic substitution reactions depends upon the electron density in the aromatic ring. Higher the electron density in the aromatic ring means higher is the rate of electrophilic substitution reactions. Now the presence of OH group in phenol, which increase the electron density at ortho and para position by positive resonance effect. So the electron density is more in phenol than in benzene. Therefore, phenol is more easily nitrated than benzene. In Kolbe reaction, instead of phenol, the phenoxide is treated with the carbon dioxide. Why? We know that the greater the ability of O- means oxide ion or phenoxide ion to donate electrons to the benzene ring. We know that phenoxide ion is more reactive than phenol towards electrophilic aromatic substitution reactions. So in other words, phenoxide ion being a stronger nucleophile reacts easily with the weak electrophile carbon dioxide to bring about the electrophilic substitution reactions. Next one. Dipole moment of phenol is smaller than the methanol. Why? In phenol, the CO bond is less polar due to the electron withdrawing or minus inductive effect of the benzene ring, wherein methanol is a more polar due to the positive inductive effect of methyl group. So as a result, right, phenol has a lower dipole moment. So phenol having a 1.54 d by, while the methanol having a 1.71 d by. Okay. Next one. Ethers can be prepared by Williamson synthesis, in which an alkyl halide is reacted with sodium alkoxide. Di-tertiary ether can't be prepared by this method. Explain. We know that the Williamson synthesis occurs by always SN2 mechanism, in which sodium alkoxide reacts with an alkyl halide. Now to prepare di-tertiary butyl ether, sodium tertiary butoxide must be reacted with a tertiary butyl bromide. So we know that tertiary alkyl halide prefers to go a elimination reactions rather than substitution reactions. It means that sodium tertiary butoxide reacts with tertiary butyl bromide and favors elimination to form isobutylene rather than substitutions to form di-tertiary butyl ether. So it's a same concept that we have to understand in our exercise also. Now we move to the another question. This is 51. The question number 51 suggests that why is the CO bond angle in alcohol is slightly less than the tetrahedral angles, where the COC bond angle in ether is slightly greater. We know that the oxygen atom in both alcohol and ether are sp3 hybridized. Okay, due to the greater lone pair then bond pair repulsion, that the concept of VACPR, the COH bond angle in alcohol is slightly lower, means 109, then the normal tetrahedral angle of 109 degree 28 minutes. But however, in ether, COC bond angles is slightly greater 110 than tetrahedral angle, which is due to the repulsion between the two bulky R groups. Okay. Next question, explain why are the lower molecular alcohol soluble in water? Simple, solubility of alcohol in water is due to the hydrogen bond. So between the hydroxyl group of the alcohol and water molecules, but the hydrocarbon part, sometimes called as an R group or alkyl group, on the other hand, tends to prevent the formation of hydrogen bonds. So this tends to decrease the solubility of alcohols in water. So lower molecular mass alcohol, the hydrocarbon part is small. Therefore, lower molecular mass alcohols are soluble in water. Next question, explain why para-nitrophenol is more acidic than phenol. Simple question. Due to the negative inductive effect and negative resonance effect, nitro group, the electron density in the OH bond decreased relative to the OH group in phenol. So, para-nitrophenol is much more acidic than phenol. Okay. Next question. Explain why the ethers and the alcohols of comparable molecular mass have different boiling points. So we know that alcohol undergo intermolecular hydrogen bonding and hence exist as associated molecules. Ethers, on the other hand, do not have hydrogen atom on the oxygen atom. So hence do not form hydrogen bond. So as a result, ether exists as a discrete molecule which are held only by weak dipole-dipole attractions. So lesser energy is required to break this weak dipole-dipole attractions than to break hydrogen bonds in associated molecule of alcohols. Therefore, the boiling points of alcohols are much higher than ethers of comparable molecular mass. Next one, 55 number question. 55, they ask like that, the carbon-oxygen bond is phenol is slightly stronger than that in methanol. Why? As a simple, due to the positive resonance effect of the OH group, phenol can be regarded as a resonance hybrid of a 5 structure that can be discussed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But out of this, structure 2, structure 3 and structure 4 contain a double bond characteristics. So CO bond in phenol have some double bond characteristics and stronger than CO bond in alcohols, which is pure single bond. Next questions, arrange a water, ethanol and phenol in increasing order of acidity and give reason for your answer. We know that due to the positive inductive effect of ethyl group, electron density in OH bond, ethanol is higher than that of the OH bond in water. Therefore, H2O is a stronger acid than ethanol. But further, due to the greater stabilization of phenoxide ion, right, over phenol, phenol is a stronger acid than water. So the acidity of these three compounds, ethanol is lesser than water, and water is lesser than phenol. Now next question is a very easy question. Is mesh the following. So we mesh the items of the column 1 and column 2 in the following questions. So we give the direct answer. Okay, the structure is called as an orthocresol. This is catechol. Next one is resorcinol. This is quinol. This is anisol. And last one is phenytol. Bahut easy hai jisme matching the columns mein agar aapke paas ek bhi option mil jata hai to hum uska option dekh ke bhi bata sakte hai ki kaun sa answer sahi hai. Next match of the column hai, next one is like that. Match the starting material given in the column 1 with the products formed by this column 2 in the reactions with HI. हमने बहुत बढ़िया तरह से ये उसको NCERT exercise में भी पढ़ा हुआ है और उसके आगे जो मैंने lecture लिया हुआ था वो जो I think so last lecture ही था उसमें भी बहुत अच्छी तरह से हमने ये पढ़ाया हुआ है कि दो methyl symmetric है तो कोई दिक्कत ही नहीं है, iodine यहाँ पे लगाओ या यहाँ पे लगाओ, no problem. तो एक बार यहाँ पे methanol आ जाएगा, जैसे हम इसको दिखा रहे हैं, जैसे ये मिथेनॉल और मिथाइल एडेड हो जाएगा. ये देखिए आप यहाँ पे क्या है, यहाँ पे थोड़ा स्टीयरिक हिंड्रेंस आपको दिख रहा है, यहाँ पे नहीं दिख रहा है, यहाँ छोटा अल्काइल ग्रुप है, तो यहाँ पे स्टीरिक हिंड्रेंस कम है, तो आयोडीन यहाँ ज्वाइंट हो जाएगा और यहाँ OH आ जाएगा। नेक्स्ट वन हम देख सकते हैं कि यह टर्शरी है, तो टर्शरी में क्या दिक्कत होती है कि टर्शरी है उसका कार्बोकेटाइन बहुत बढ़िया स्टेबिलाइज होता है, तो आयोडीन यहाँ पे ज्वाइंट हो जाएगा और मिथेनॉल निकल जाएगा। और उसके बाद में हमने बताया हुआ है एनी सॉल है, तो ये तो सिंपल है, यहाँ पे डबल बॉन्ड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स हमें दिखाई दे रहा है, तो CH3I के साथ जुड़ेगा और OH हो जाएगा। नेक्स्ट वन हमको 59 नंबर में दिया हुआ है, मैच द फॉलोइंग आइटम्स ऑफ द कॉलम वन विद द आइटम्स ऑफ कॉलम बी। एंटी फ्रीज विच इज यूज इन कार इंजिन, एंटी फ्रीज कौन सा हम यूज करते हैं कार इंजिन में, इथिलीन ग्लाइकोल या इंथेन 1,2-diol। सोलवेंट यूज इन परफ्यूम्स वो इथेनॉल ही है। स्टार्टिंग मटेरियल पिक्रिक एसिड का फिनॉल है। वुड स्पिरिट यानी हम बता रहे हैं उसको मिथेनॉल। रिएजेंट यूज फॉर द डिटेक्शन ऑफ फिनोलिक ग्रुप इज न्यूट्रल FeCl3, बिकॉज विद द हेल्प ऑफ न्यूट्रल FeCl3 व्हेन रिएक्ट्स विद फिनोलिक ग्रुप, एनी फिनोलिक ग्रुप, दे गिव द येलो प्रेसिपिटेट्स और येलो कलराइजेशन। बाय प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ सॉप इंडस्ट्रीज यूज इन कॉस्मेटिक्स इज अ ग्लिसरॉल, राइट। नेक्स्ट वन एंड टूडेज लास्ट वन इज 60 नंबर, इज मैच द आइटम्स ऑफ कॉलम वन विद आइटम्स ऑफ कॉलम टू, मिथेनॉल। सो मिथेनॉल इट्स अ वुड स्पिरिट। कॉल्बेस रिएक्शंस है वो कहाँ कौन से ली है, कॉल्बेस रिएक्शन इज फॉर टू मैन्युफैक्चर सैलिसिलिक एसिड, सो इट्स कन्वर्जन ऑफ फिनोल टू ऑर्थो हाइड्रोक्सी सैलिसिलिक एसिड। विलियमसन सिंथेसिस है वो रिएक्शन ऑफ अल्काइल हैलाइड विद सोडियम अल्कोक्साइड है। कन्वर्जन ऑफ सेकेंडरी अल्कोहल टू कीटोन, राइट, तो हम किसके हीटेड कॉपर 8573 से कर सकते हैं। रिमर्टिमन रिएक्शन टू मैन्युफैक्चर्ड सैलिसाइल्डिहाइड फ्रॉम फिनॉल एंड फर्मेंटेशन इज फॉर इथाइल अल्कोहल। सो टुडे वी स्टॉप एट हियर एंड नेक्स्ट सेशंस वी कंटिन्यू विथ अवर जर्नी ऑफ दिस NCERT एग्जाम्पलर। नाउ आई थिंक सो द लास्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दिस अल्कोहल फिनॉल्स एंड ईथर ऑफ दिस एग्जाम्पलर। ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच।